Okay, now that we can convert a relative URL to an absolute URL, let's use it to fix our page a little bit. So I'm going to go back to source and remove that breakpoint and continue. And then I don't need this anymore, so I'm going to get rid of it. And then what I'm going to do is, before I move the content, I'm going to fix the URLs. I guess it should be URLs. And so let's go ahead and write that function. So function fix URLs. And in order to do that, I want to fix tags, image tags. I want to adjust the URL in the source. And then script tags, I want to also adjust the source. And then link tags, I want to adjust href. And I'm also going to want to do something to the anchors. Let me just fix those for now, and then I'll come back to that. I need to do something special for anchors, but I'll just do this for now. So that should be enough to start. And then to fix tags, so this is going to take a tag name and an attribute. So the first thing I want to do is get all the tags that have this particular tag name. So var tags is document.get elements by tag name. And then for var counter is 0, counter less than tags dot length, counter plus plus. Var adder is equal to tags sub counter dot get attribute. And then if adder tag sub counter set attribute, comma, relative to absolute of adder. Let's actually call that URL. And that should be it for now. Let's go ahead and reload and see what we get. Did we call fix URLs? Yes. So let's go ahead and open image in new tab. Put a breakpoint here, make sure we're getting here. Okay, so tag sub counter. So this is a script tag. And here's the source. So URL is fetchpage.js. Let's step. And now let's look at the source. So now it's eloquentjavascript.net/, oh, fetchpage.js. That's not right. What was this URL? So I should have tags in console. Tags sub 0 dot source. Tags sub 1 dot source. Oh, that's actually the wrong place. There should be contents. I'm changing my document, not my contents. Okay, so let's go ahead and continue and reload. There we go. So there's my images. It looks like it's styled. Nice. So let's go ahead and click on one of these links. It should take me to the right page on Eloquent JavaScript, and it does. Great. And to verify, I can go F12 and look at the network tab, and we'll see what works and what doesn't. So everything worked. Everything was found except for this font. So this is a font, and if I click on it, I don't get any information here, but if I go to the console, I see this message. So access to font at whatever from origin localhost has been blocked by cross-origin resource sharing policy. So this is what I was talking about before. So JavaScript on my localhost web server is trying to, or the JavaScript, the browser is parked on localhost for this page. So the JavaScript that's running on this page is trying to access a resource on eloquentjavascript.net. So that's cross-origin. So the origin of this page is localhost, and it's trying to access a resource on eloquentjavascript.net. And that's disallowed by policy unless eloquentjavascript.net has configured their web server to include this response header when I try to fetch this content. And it doesn't, so I'm out of luck. Now, if I actually look for sinzelbold.waf, view page source, and it's probably in the style sheet. Yeah, so here's where it's actually getting loaded. It's getting loaded from the CSS. And digging through the style stuff at this point is more work than I really want to do. So I'm just going to leave that one be for now, because I'm still getting most of the page. And this looks pretty good for now. So in the next video, what I want to do is, instead of having these links go to eloquentjavascript.net, I want them to go back to fetchpage.php, but I want them to include that whole URL as a parameter.